Hey guys, welcome back to the King of Random. Today we're going to be trying an experiment I've seen some people do before, but haven't seen very well explained. We're going to try to be making what's called fire snakes, a combination of burning sugar and baking soda in a base of sand. We're going to try a few different combinations of regular sugar, powdered sugar, baking soda, and two different types of accelerant to see what gives us the very best result. We've got a giant bag of sand and some metal trays to burn our sugar in, so let's get started. Now, all of my research indicates that it should be 4 parts of sugar to 1 part baking soda by weight. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try 3 things. We're gonna have our regular sugar mixed with our baking soda. We're going to have our powdered sugar mixed with our baking soda. And then we're also going to try mixing some of our regular sugar with the baking soda and then blending it up so we have an even finer powder. We'll see how that does in comparison. We'll take all 3 of those mixtures and try burning each of them with alcohol and lighter fluid and see which of our 6 combinations gives us the best results. White powders everywhere. Twenty grams of regular sugar, and I will add 5 grams of baking soda. I'll mix up another one of the same thing, which I'll blend in just a minute. One thing that might cause a different result with the powdered sugar is most powdered sugar actually also has some cornstarch in it to help keep it from caking together too much. 5 grams of baking soda. Now let's get a little blender and blend up one of the mixtures of regular sugar and baking soda. Guess unsurprisingly, that now kind of looks like powdered sugar. All right, we've got our 3 different trays for our 3 different mixtures. Let's fill these up with sand. My first fuel is 91% concentration of isopropyl alcohol, also known as rubbing alcohol. My other one is a common barbecue lighter fluid. I'm going to pour some of each fluid on one side of the sand, and then we'll put little piles of each kind of sugar on that. So overall, we'll have 6 different combinations of sugar and fuel going at once. So here we've got granulated sugar and alcohol as the fuel. Here we've got granulated sugar and lighter fluid as the fuel. Blended sugar with alcohol, blended sugar, lighter fluid, powdered sugar, alcohol, powdered sugar, lighter fluid. A little harder time getting the lighter fluid to light than the alcohol. So that's 1 point for alcohol. On that one, it lit well. Here we go. So let's take a little bit of a look at what is happening here. As the sugar burns, it bubbles and boils and turns black and turns into just basically carbon. Some of the gases being let off by the baking soda are actually filling the molten sugar as it's created. It doesn't just turn into a puddle of black sugar, it turns into a sort of expanded foam of black sugar. Well, here we go. Here's the results of our test. The powdered sugar definitely started making the fire snakes the fastest. They took off pretty quickly. The powdered sugar with the lighter fluid never got very far. We only got this one little weird stumpy thing, which still looks pretty cool, but it's not very big. You can see most of the sugar is still just kind of there, clumped together. Another interesting point, something I want to talk about, is that if you've seen videos of this before, it doesn't occur to you how unbelievably lightweight this stuff is, because you have a pile of sugar That's all of the mass, and then it's just expanded out to this large snake. So this thing weighs almost nothing. It's like styrofoam. Look at this. It's also incredibly fragile. Look at this. It just comes right apart. You can see how light and fluffy it is inside. And then if I crush it, it basically just turns into dust. You saw, like, you just watch dust fly up off of it. Powdered sugar with alcohol. That one worked great. It started off very quickly. It kept going for quite a while. There is still a lump of unburned sugar down at the bottom, but it's pretty small. It really got most of it. That grew and twisted around, and we got like a secondary growth coming off of it at one point. It was pretty good. That's a lot of big black snake. Curls wonderfully. I don't know if you can get this on camera. There's even little bits of iridescent sort of color going through parts of this. That looks pretty neat. So powdered sugar with alcohol as a fuel, that worked really well. Our blended sugar with the lighter fluid got basically nowhere. Almost all of the sugar mixed with the baking soda is still here, didn't burn. We got a little bit of result, but not a lot. Blended sugar with the alcohol, it took a while, and then it did start growing, but it didn't get very far. It's not bad. That does kind of look like a cool demon horn, some sort of cancerous sand growth or something. Not bad. Granulated sugar with lighter fluid, again, not very impressive. I took this piece off to try and let some of the sugar inside get a little more access to the heat. Didn't really seem to do much. This still looks cool, but it's very small. Didn't go very far. I'm actually gonna try eating a tiny bit of this. It's gonna taste terrible. I'm hoping this inner part will just taste like burned sugar and it won't all taste just like carbon. There's also baking soda in it, so it's like salty burned sugar. Ugh. Yeah, it's terrible. Granulated sugar and alcohol. This took a good while to start doing anything. Like, it took a long time for it to get beyond just this first little bit, but eventually it started growing really well, and it just kept going until, even though it is very lightweight, eventually it had enough weight to just break a piece off, and then it started making another piece, and then that one broke off, and then another piece came and that broke off, and then it just kept on going. So I think we definitely got the most volume out of the granulated sugar eventually. The powdered sugar definitely took off faster, but in the end, I think the granulated sugar was the most fire snakey of all. Oh, it's pretty close tie between those two. I actually liked both of them pretty well, but I'm gonna say that the granulated sugar was my favorite just because it kept going and diminishing and getting smaller and smaller. I think it's pretty clear that the 91% isopropyl alcohol that we were using is a much better fuel than the lighter fluid. So, isopropyl alcohol, very good. Granulated sugar or powdered sugar, both quite good. Blended sugar, not really so good, so we're not gonna use that anymore. Well, I'm gonna clean this up, and then I have a couple ideas of how to scale this up to something a little bit larger. It just disappears. I'm gonna use our powdered sugar mix for this one because it started going fastest. You can use the alcohol, of course, because that worked way better. And I'm just gonna set up like a whole bunch of different spots on one tray of sand, and I'm gonna hope they kind of grow together into one giant fire flame smoke log. We'll see what happens. All right. That looks good, let's light it up. That's lit and it's going. All the little parts. That was pretty cool. It wasn't exactly what I was hoping for. I was hoping for we'd just kind of get like a large column of this stuff rising up, and that didn't really work out. But it did get some good volume. We got quite a bit of the black snake material, which looked a little bit cooler while it was still on the tray. And a couple of times I cleared it off so we could like let the new stuff grow in without all the weight of what was on there crushing it down. Overall, pretty neat. I've got one more thing that I want to try. And it's gonna take up a little more space. for all of these ones, I am using the powdered sugar rather than the granulated sugar, just because it starts going faster. I still think the granulated sugar might be better for a total result in getting the biggest, longest snakes, but I just didn't want to wait for it this time. Now we've got 13 fire snakes going at once. I've spread them out a little bit more so that they hopefully won't bond together like they were in the last one. This way I'm hoping we just get 13 different snakes rising a foot or two off of the tray. Well, there we go. 13 different black snakes all in one tray altogether, making this sort of weird, twisted field of gnarled, growing things. I don't even know what to call them. But that looks pretty cool. That was fun to do. And guys, this experiment is so easy. Powdered sugar, baking soda, and rubbing alcohol. You just put that in a little bit of sand and light it, and you get this. It's like the cheapest experiment you could ever do, and it looks so cool. I found that I had really good results using both granulated sugar and powdered sugar. The powdered sugar started working a little bit faster. The granulated sugar kept going longer. So you kind of have to choose which one you prefer. I definitely found that the 91% rubbing alcohol worked better as a fuel than the lighter fluid. I think it started better. I think it burned more consistently and it just gave us better results in the end. If you're trying this at home, make sure you're doing it in a place with good ventilation. Make sure you're not going to light anything on fire around you and you have proper safety equipment to put anything out. But this is absolutely something you can do at home. Thanks for joining us for this project today and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. So now I'm going to see how quickly I can vacuum all of this up so it's just gone. Probably the most satisfying thing to vacuum that I've ever vacuumed. It just goes everywhere.
Hey guys, I know there are so many great videos and great YouTubers out there that you could be watching instead of the King of Random, so I just want to say how grateful I am that you choose to watch us.